going to show you some stretching that you probably have seen in the previous videos, but I thought I could talk through some of the stretching I do and how to do them well. We'll see. Basically, I start from the top and go all the way down in terms of stretching all my joints. Neck. My whole body is relaxed. Left, right, as far as you can, relax. Do you feel stretching here? Sideways, same thing, you feel the stretching here. This is relax. Don't lift any shoulders. Around and up. All the way and back. All the way and back. Shoulders. Do a full rotation. So all you do is you concentrate on the shoulders. You're not tensing any other muscles, just the shoulders moving. Arms with a shoulders movement. Stretch all up. Keep your legs straight. Now stretch to the back. So it's important to stretch your back this way. This helps when you're receiving a technique and you're falling to the ground. You're stretching all your back here at the bottom and your neck. So it's a good exercise. Keeping your feet flat. And you feel squeezing from the back to the buttock. Now, stretch these muscles. If your knee is going to the middle between behind your legs and your elbow, I meant. Now, stretch, stretch. It's not the arms, but hips, 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 hips. Rotate your hips, rotate your hips. So begin from the head, shoulders, hips, and then we'll go further down, stretching the knee and the leg as well. So you keep both legs facing forward, so not one leg like this, they're both facing forward. So you feel the stretch of the back leg, and then you push forward, and here you've got this extension, and you stretch your body, keeping the core centered and focused. Back, same thing. Four. Stretching the knees and all those muscles behind the leg and using the core of the body. You should feel the stretching here when you go up. Stretch muscles here, there, and contract your abdomen all the way up. Now, lift one leg. The trick is, you've got to keep standing leg bent. If it's straight, you could lose your balance. If you leave it bent slightly, and look at one spot. So you stay onto one spot fix. So there, one spot. Stretch. Without putting it on the floor, stretch, fix onto one spot, keep that legs flex, stretch, come back, stretch, same thing, keep it flexed slightly and keep looking at one spot, stretch, without putting it on the floor. Now, keep those legs straight, down, and in fact, your body must be relaxed, no tension. You go down and you breathe out. You begin to feel the stretch on both of your legs here. So, side, same thing, you keep it stretch, stretch, so arms relax, hip, leg like this, you sit as if there's a chair, and what you're doing is you're stretching your legs here. Move to one side and the other. It's quite a nice stretching. I quite like doing that movement there. It keeps your body supple. Now go back into this mode facing. So now I've done a little bit of stretch, I can go slightly more. In fact, it's easier to make leg in facing. It keeps my leg straight easier. So move my leg more slightly, so I do a split a little bit further, and again breathe out. Here is a good exercise to keep the core centered. you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. What did I say? Stretch now here. Put your legs in. Stretch your knees. Okay. So from here, go back. This time you stretch one leg. Keep it straight and down. Keep the foot flat as you can onto the ground first. Step in. Up. Bring your body down. Your knee. Relax. Your legs should be relaxed. Relax. You only do, you feel the stretch here at the back. Straight and leg back. Now what I tend to do is I'm going straight in. I want to keep my hips mobile, so I stretch my hips, putting both hands in the ground. Stretch to the ground. Stretch to the bent leg. In between. And into the straight leg. Again. Same exercise with the other leg. Keep your hands flat. So you feel the stretch here. Flat. And down. And down. Leg is up. What you do is you push with your elbows and you breathe out gently. Always, when you stretch, breathe out. Because you're stretching your tendons on the inside of your quads, never raise your legs up on their own. Always bring them up with your hands. Forward. Again, back straight. Stretch. Back stretch. Stretch. Back straight. And really go down, you breathe out, relax. So you aim for your toes. These knees together, legs together, and if you're going up like this, then don't go as far, just go where you can. You breathe out. So what you do is you get the benchmark, you start here, that's okay. Then you do a little bit more next time, and a little bit more, to a point where you can reach your toes. Again, more stretch, bring your feet together. Now you do a split. And it's the same principle. You're stretching your tendons, stretching your legs. It increases your suppleness, your mobility of your joints, and your hips. And overall, you become a much better Aikidoka when you receive techniques, because you suddenly feel you've got the mobility to receive a technique that perhaps you haven't had before. So I always say before a class, if you can do a bit of stretching, do it, or at home on a regular basis. It will help you to receive the techniques. So you breathe out and stretch your leg. Yeah, put your elbows in if you can, and breathe out. What I tend to do also is stretch my arms as far as I can and do some cocky feeling with my hands. One whale feeling. Is you also stretch your ankles. Apply pressure points. This is to re-energize your body and stretch your toes, and also stretch. And what you do is you shake, shake, shake. Sensation on your feet. Stretch, stretch your toes, stretch your toes this way. The city in Seza, something I haven't spoken before. But what I tend to do is the big toe is on the other big toe. So that depends. Some people would prefer doing it like that. Some people would do it like that. But to me, the toe on the other toe feels quite strong. And it's like a triangle shape. The back straight and shoulders very relaxed. Yeah, that's a good sitting position. Stretching all your legs in. So if you find it difficult, do it for a few minutes, come off it, start again the following day and so forth, but gradually it will increase your mobility, and it's actually quite good. You feel good posture, good center, and There's something about the bowing as well. There's some people bow like this, that they still have the center here. I personally feel that you need to keep your back straight, and if you're going to do both hands, you do it forward and keep your back straight, and also keep your eyes looking forward as well, so you're not just looking to the ground. So when you have a picture of O-sensei or Sato-sensei on the wall and you begin a class, then it's completely different, because it's ultimate bowing, I think. When you bow to your students, this is my view on this. Please keep your eyes. Not saying someone will come and attack, but if that did ever happen, you're ready. Now, when you stand up, it's not just doing this, it's actually bringing your toes up. So, there, you feel power, and then you sit more in. So, there, relax. So you have to stand up. Stretch your back more. Your legs straight and your back straight as well. Lean forward and stretch. Really good exercise. Now, exercise to get strength from the core. Gives you some strength and stamina. Same thing. Thank you. arms up, so you lift your buttock. Now your body is lifted. What I always do is finish off my exercise down. So you can flexi our legs and stretch them straight. Hope you enjoyed it.